Hello, ladies and gentlemen. On 22nd of December 2023, the Age reported Fusionex to shuttle following court order. Interesting thingy regarding Fusionex. Disclaimer, this is an educational video to share with Uncle Auntie Arvin Alien on two things. Number one, how to conduct due diligence and data analysis based on primary data sources. After reading any secondary or tertiary data. Number two, how to understand the intricacies of Companies Act 2016, companies winding up, and financial statements. Fusionex to shutter following court order. Interesting thingy number one, we can't seem to find any court order lodged to SSM. Interesting thingy number two, the announcement was first made by the H and not sole shareholder, Hitachi. Under Companies Act 2016, there are two ways in which a company may be wound up. Ta-da! So Fusionex is which one leh? To find out leh, take note of three sentences in the H article. Number one, Fusionex has wound up following a court order. Number two, Group CEO Hiroyuki said that the winding up of Fusio Tech Holdings Sindrian Berhad and 12 other wholly owned subsidiaries. Number three, Hitachi takes over and decides to liquidate the organization. Hitachi is the 100% shareholder of Fusio Tech Holdings Sindrian Berhad. We have not cited the court order, but we tried to reverse engineer and deduce that Fusionex Group might be wound up by the court. Compulsory winding up law and under Companies Act Section 465 sub 1 sub A via special resolution passed by Hitachi, which is the 100% shareholder of Fusio Tech Holdings in Sindrian Berhad. Interesting thing number 3. Fusionex appeared to be a successful company. April 10, 2020, Hitachi made this announcement that it has acquired Fusionex brand as a wholly owned subsidiary on April 1st, 2020. Fusionex is also an award-winning organization. They also seem to be rubbing shoulders with a lot of VVIP, ministers, and also Prime Minister. When we pass by PJ Hall, we see their logo big la. When we pass by the Federal Highway Hall, we see their signboard sui wo. So the company so steady pom pee pee, how come suddenly wind up? Interesting thingy number 4. The corporate structure of Fusionex Group. Ta-da! If you want to download the clearer PDF version, you can enroll for free at learnaby.com/p/removed because I do not know whether this video will be removed again by YouTube or not. So in the audited financial statement hall, there are these subsidiaries lah. So for better data visualization and data storytelling leh, we draw the corporate structure for you all to see lah. Too small ho. Let me zoom big for you all to see ha. Fusio Tech Holdings Sindrian Berhad is 100% owned by Hitachi. Under Fusio Tech Holdings, there are 4 subsidiaries, 2 Malaysia, 2 in Hong Kong. The Malaysia subsidiary, there are Fusionex Connect Sindrian Berhad and Fusionex Technology Sindrian Berhad. Under Fusionex Connect Sindrian Berhad, there is a few subsidiaries. Let's look at Fusionex Technology Sindrian Berhad. There are 2 subsidiaries, Fusionex Corp Sindrian Berhad and ADV Fusionex Sindrian Berhad. Under Fusionex Corp Sindrian Berhad, there are 3 subsidiaries. One, the Malaysia subsidiary is Fusionex Solutions Inc. Sindrian Berhad. Under ADV Fusionex Sindrian Berhad, there are 5 subsidiaries. 3 in Malaysia. So number 1 is Fusionex Innovation Sindrian Berhad, Fusionex Capital Sindrian Berhad, which is a dormant company, and Fusionex Academy Sindrian Berhad. All the Malaysian company, they are governed under Companies Act 2016, which is under SSM, an agency under the Ministry of Domestic Trade and Cost of Livings. these companies are regulated, legitimate, then how come suddenly got this winding up news one? According to the Age article, Hitachi takes over and decides to liquidate the organization pending some investigation. What are the duties of a liquidator leh? Hey, to investigate the affairs and assets of a wound-up company. B, to investigate the conduct of the company directors and other related persons. Number 3, to investigate claims made by creditors and third parties. And number 4, to collect and realize the company's asset to meet its liabilities. In summary, when a company goes for liquidation, the liquidator tai sai la. Interesting thing, the financial statement. Ta-da! This is Fusiotech Holdings St. John Berhad 3 years financial comparison. What do you see? Abstracting data is one skill. Analyzing data is another skill. Anyone can acquire and learn this skill. It is called the capology skill. If you are capochi enough, you shall master the art of smelling interesting thingy in the financial statement. Fusionex got innovation and technology la ma. Lenabi got oxidation and capology la. Continuous increase of the non-current asset of Fusiotech Holdings Syndrome Berhad. The revenue of Fusiotech Holdings Berhad in year 2023 is around 834 million. And most of the revenue come from the subsidiary, which is Fusionex Technology. It is also interesting to note that the profit increased 71.2 million, but the non-current asset increased 608 million. Very interesting. We have looked at Fusiotech Holdings, Fusiotech Technology, and next, the interesting company is in Fusionex Innovations, Sanjiran Berhad. The second major factor of the big variance in intangible assets of Fusiotech Holdings, Sanjiran Berhad, is Fusionex Innovations, Sanjiran Berhad. The interesting thingy in Fusionex Innovations, Sanjiran Berhad, is the sharp increase of the intangible asset. We look at the revenue and cost of sale in year 2021 and year 2022. We take those figures and put side by side in note number 4, intangible asset, so that you can appreciate the interesting thingy about this. So you can see the development cost at 1st of April year 2020, the addition is 145 million. So the cost is 132 million. You add these two up, is 277 million, which is below the revenue, 328 million. Then when you look at year 2021 to 2022, the addition is 318 million. The cost is 210 million. Ta-da! The interesting thing is the total is 528 million, which is above the revenue, which is 387 million. Next, we look at the audited financial statement of year 2023. The intangible asset rose drastically to 753 million. We do the same thing. Then next, if we look at year 2023, the addition is 468 million plus. And if we add the cost of 352 million, the total is 820 million, which is much more than the revenue, 565 million. This is the cash flow statement of Fusiotech Holdings, Sanjiran Berhad. We can see that the company continuously increased their acquisition of intangible assets. The graph in red shows net cash, shortfall without new funding. The graph in blue shows decline in cash. Year 2021, 478 million. Decline to 256 million in year 2022. And further decline to 183 million in year 2023. Next, we see who they trust with their cash. In note number 12, deposits with licensed financial institution. Means bank FD licensed by Bank Negara lo. Interest rate leh, mama dei la. But they also know keep cash in bank FD very safe and more trustworthy la ma. According to the age, Ivan Tay resigned from his post at Fusiotech with immediate effect on December 6th with other key resignation. When we look at section 58, notification of change in the register of directors, we found that Ivan Tay resigned on 6th of December. Another director, Tan Chen Chiang, he resigned on the 4th of December. Ivan Tay and Tan were the two directors who signed on the audited financial statement of Fusiotech Holdings Sdn. Bhd. Tan is the director primarily responsible for the financial management. So with Ivan Tay and Tan's resignation, currently the board of directors, they are all foreigner, all Japanese. Under section 196 of Companies Act, directors of company, this means a foreign company can appoint all directors who are non-Malaysians so long as one of them is a resident in Malaysia. We call him or her resident director. In Fusionex case, the resident director is Hoshiaki Hanafusa. Ta-da! This is the directorship of Ivan Tay la. Out of the six company, three already dissolved. And if the company status is existing one, he already resigned. And the shareholding information of Ivan Tay is two companies. But these two companies, Fusionex Consulting Sdn. Bhd and Enex Celsius, already dissolved one more. According to the H article, Dato Sri Ivan Tay, who was named as EY Technology Entrepreneur of the Year Malaysia in year 2014. This award must be very, very prestigious award la. So prestigious, until Robert Kwok and Kwek Leng Chan also cannot get this award. Okay, I've shared interesting thingy regarding Fusionex, Hitachi's investment in Malaysia. Interesting thingy at the financial statement, we look at the non-current asset and the intangible asset compared with the revenue and cost of sale. Besides that, we look at increase of acquisition of intangible asset and decline in cash year after year. As a conclusion, Malaysia has many multi-award-winning successful entrepreneurs and interesting business opportunities. Most people focus on legitimate, regulated, and branding to determine business success. However, in the real business world, capology analysis on financial statement and OCDictive study on the cash flow, means the real money, not the paper profit, is the key to business sustainability. Warren Buffett, he came up with simple rule for auntie, uncle, abeng, alien to follow. Rule number one, never lose money. Rule number two, never forget about rule number one. As the world is caught up with the advancement of technology and disruptive innovation, people tend to forget this one simple golden rule. Show me the money! Remember, you be like me. Duty and kepo to see money.
Money, money, money. Come and show me. It's a business world. Money, money, money. Capology in financial world. All the things that you show, if you cannot show the money, set for business world. Money is one word.
The which also reported that it is expected to affect over 500 employees. New Year is around the corner. We hope that the affected employees will persevere and overcome the challenges ahead. Thank you. Goodbye. Namaste. Mm-hmm.